anything you would associate with Rick and Morty after their 11 years on the air. It's a super dramatic, atmospheric, quiet, painfully drawn-out anime that feels like something Rick and Morty would do as an anime parody. Yet it's played completely straight. So while I can applaud it for doing something different from the main show, it's too much of a difference to the point that the show loses its identity and audience members become increasingly alienated by it. And really, that's all I can say about it. This show does not feel like Rick and Morty at all. And that would be one thing if the show itself was good or entertaining in any capacity, but it's just a boring slog. A confusing mess that's only going to be a good curiosity. Just don't bother. That may be harsh to say towards a show that only has one of 10 episodes out right now, but if a show makes this much of a bad impression from the get-go, and the rest of the show from what we've seen follows in its footsteps, then I don't mind jumping the gun here. I don't see how the show can suddenly resurrect the energy and identity of Rick and Morty after making it abundantly clear that they're discarding it and doing their own thing. Who is the show made for? I genuinely have no idea. I'm not even a Rick and Morty fan anymore. That ship sailed a long time ago, but I would still take season 5 something out now.
We need to save Ruthia's mother. She went to Mount Safar to obtain this mana source, but the Canaanites need to continue, Canaanites. Then again, my arm is... Perhaps with this powerful arm, I'll be able to break through walls that are already starting to crack. Okay! So, now we can do that, too. Sparked him to exist. The voice came from within, the first spoken words ever to be uttered. When Ahix opened his eyes, a flood of knowledge entered him. He knew all had come before, what was before him now, and what could come in the future. His intelligence could identify every possible future event. Billions of possibilities came into him at once, and he understood them all. The Dinjur were there as well. El and Asherah, Ahix's companions, who would become his greatest adversary. From his disordered existence of ruin and chaos, Ahix formed order. He brought the forces of existence under his control and modeled with land and sea, placing them from what was once nothing came something, from what was once bad came good, a marvelous feat that would make all of creation bow down to him. "Wake up, Cain," spoke Ahix, his father shaking the tree. Cain opened his eyes for the first time. "I'll give you the knowledge and power to make more like you." Cain bowed his head. He would make a family, and he would lead them to Ahix, and together they would all live in harmony. Elena and Asherah, the Dinjur, grew jealous of Cain and the Cainites. Cain would be their brother, Ahix told the Dinjur, but the Dinjur would have none of it. They did not care for family. They only wanted power for themselves, the power to come at a time when Ahix's defenses were lowered. The great Ahix did not anticipate the Dinjur's betrayals. He did not see it well with his all-seeing eyes. Ahix's fall was swift. His power disintegrated into nothing, and as his power lessened, Indonites, would you care to try Canaanite cuisine? Should I be? If you were here to do us harm, I think you would have done it by now. Besides, Augensahone told us we had nothing to be afraid of and that you were friends. I refuse to question Augensahone, who have lived for generations. They know best. Besides, perhaps the more you learn about our people, the less like this. Okay, that did cross my mind the second, like, no one else in the city was, like, running from us anymore. We eat everything. When Ahix made us, he gave us the function to enjoy food. I say enjoy food because we don't truly need it. Canines live off the sarks embedded in our chests. So long as the sarks burn brightly, we survive. But the Anakim, our greatest warriors, believe that our mechanical limbs and knowledge of the land. Here. That's right, this is my home. I don't remember ever living on the surface. The Yabzu was all I've known for so many years. So we couldn't risk Indonites finding us. We didn't know if your people would try to live in the garrets. There are some rumblings amongst prophets and oracles about expanding civilization. Mother also looked like them. I later found out that unlike the Indonites, my mother doesn't have a koshin embedded in her chest. The watchmen there must have been five or six of them. Were surprised to see me too. Thank you.